إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله Indeed the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ And every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدٍ My dear brothers in Islam, we continue to remind ourselves day in and day out because of Allah's statement, وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ To remind one another, because reminding benefits the believers. So we continue to remind ourselves with the rights and the etiquettes of the Muslim in general, but especially towards their other Muslim brothers and sisters in Islam. This is the rights and the etiquettes of the Muslims towards one another. And we come to the point where we should remind ourselves of the etiquette that the Muslim should not backbite, nor scorn, nor insult, nor ridicule one another. Again, this is not the way of a believer to do towards anybody, but especially towards the Muslim. It's a higher sin if they commit these crimes. Nor should he call another Muslim by offensive names or spread evil tales about him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He clarified this in Surah Al-Hujurat. When He said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا جُتَّنِبُوا كَثِيرًا مِّنَ الظَّنِّ إِنَّ بَعْضَ الظَّنِّ إِثْمٍ وَلَا تَجَسَّسُوا وَلَا يَغْطَبْ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا أَيُحِبُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَنْ يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ مَيْتًا فَكَرِهْتُمُوهُ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, what means, O you who believe? Again, any time we hear this entry of يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا O you who believe, then the ones who want to be amongst the believers on the day of resurrection should be listening loud and clear. With nothing else to bother them or concern them or distract them, so that they implement what is about to be addressed. O you who believe, avoid much suspicion. Do not be suspicious of one another. Indeed, some suspicion is sin. And spy not on one another, nor should you backbite one another. Would one of you like to eat the flesh of his dead brother? You would hate to do so. You would hate to have to eat the flesh of your dead brother or sister in Islam to survive. So because you hate this, you should hate backbiting as well. So fear Allah. And Allah, He also said as a reminder to us, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا يَسْخَرْ قَوْمٌ مِّن قَوْمٍ عَسَىٰ أَن يَكُونُوا خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ وَلَا نِسَاءٌ مِّن نِسَاءٍ عَسَىٰ أَن يَكُنَّ خَيْرًا مِّنْهُنْ وَلَا تَنَابَزُوا وَلَا تَلْمِزُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَلَا تَنَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَابِ بِئْسَ الْإِسْمُ الْفُسُوقَ بَعْدَ الْإِيمَانِ وَمَنْ لَمْ يَتُبْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ Allah says what means, again, O you who believe, we should be listening loud and clear if we want to be in this group. Let not one group of you scoff at another group, insult another group, look down on another group. It may be that they're better than you. And let not the believing women scoff at another group of women. Let them not look down at them or think they are better than them. It may be that that other group you are mocking is better than you. Do not defame one another, nor insult one another by nicknames. How bad is it to insult one's brother after having faith? And whosoever does not repent from this, they will be from the zalimun, the wrongdoers. My brothers in Islam, the brotherhood of Islam, the sisterhood of Islam, this transcends your culture. It transcends your nationality. It transcends your wealth status. It transcends your status in general of whoever you may be. All of this, this brotherhood, it transcends all of those other things that we have come to naturally put first in our lives. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أتدرون ما الغيبة. The Prophet ﷺ, he asked the companions, do you know what is backbiting? فَقَالُوا أَلَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَعْلَمُ. They responded, Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam know best. So Allah, He said to them to clarify, ذِكْرُكُ أَخَاكَ بِمَا يَكْرَهُ. He said, it is to say something about your brother that he hates. So they questioned the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam further. Okay, but what if what we're saying about our brother, even though he may hate it, what if it's the truth? We actually saw him doing this and we're not lying, we're not spreading a false tale. So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, إِنْ كَانَ فِيهِ مَا تَقُولُ فَقَدْ اخْتَبْتَهُ وَإِنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ فِيهِ مَا تَقُولُ فَقَدْ بَهَتَّهُ رَوَاهُ مُسْلِمُ. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he clarified the end of this, saying, if what you say about your brother behind his or her back, behind brother or sister behind his or her back, and it is truly found in him, then this is still ghibah, this is backbiting. This is equivalent to eating the flesh of your dead brother. And if what you're saying is not truly found in him, you're making up a lie, or it's based on a suspicion, then this is slander, and it takes a worser crime. My dear brothers in Islam, in another hadith, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, لا يدخل الجنة قتات. رواه بخاري ومسلم. In the authentic hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was reported to have said that a tale spreader will not enter Jannah. Someone who just tells stories, and we may think, oh, this is very common again amongst the women. It is very common again amongst the men, that they spread tales. A tale is something which is not true, something which may make the people curious or question their brother or sister in faith. The tale spreader will not enter paradise. From the rights of the Muslim upon the Muslim, and the etiquettes of the Muslim towards their Muslim brother and sister in Islam, is that you should not revile one another, even the ones who are dead, and even the ones who are alive, without due right. This is based on the authentic hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, سباب المسلم فسوق وقتاله كفر. This is based on the authentic hadith in the Sahih of Bukhari and Muslim, where the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, abusing a Muslim is evil and wickedness. Whether you verbally abuse them or physically abuse them, and killing or fighting them, fighting against him or her is kufr. It's a very grave sin, a very great sin, that you should commit it. ثُمَّ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ لَا يَرْمِي رَجُلٌ رَجُلًا بِالْفِسْقِ أَوْ الْكُفْرِ إِلَّا ارْتَدَّ عَلَيْهِ إِنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ صَاحِبَهُ كَذَلِكَ. This hadith which we find in the Sahih of Bukhari, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, a person does not cast on any other person wickedness, evil, or kufr, unbelief, except that it returns to him if it was not becoming of his companion. Meaning, when you claim that someone is evil or wicked, when you claim that someone is a disbeliever, and unfortunately, this is on our tongues, where we actually will say to someone who is a Muslim, who we don't know maybe too much about, because of some action we see, we may say they're a kafir or a disbeliever. What's going to happen to that in that case is that either that person truly is as you say, but if it is not, then that tag that you gave them will return to you. So be mindful of what you say about the people. Be mindful of what tales you spread. Be mindful of the suspicion you make. Control your tongues to restrain them from ascribing someone to evil, wickedness, or kufr, disbelief. وَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ لَا تُصُبُّ الْأَمْوَاتِ فَإِنَّهُمْ قَدْ أَفْضَوْا إِلَى مَا قَدَّمُوا رواه البخاري. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, do not abuse the ones who are dead, for they have reached the result of the deeds that they put forth in this life. Many times, even though someone has been deceased or died in the beginning, and even years later, someone will still talk about the sins they used to commit that they witnessed, or say, repeat the things that the person used to say. Leave the ones who have died to their destination, because they have met already what their sins put forth. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ادعوا الله يغفر لكم ذنوبكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهدي ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. My dear brothers in Islam, from this also, يعني this right and etiquette towards one another and not reviling one another comes how we may insult another brother or sister, and that insult actually comes back upon you. Or if you insult their parents, it comes back on your parents. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من الكبائر شتم الرجل ووالديه قالوا وهل يشتم الرجل والديه قال نعم يسب أبا الرجل فيسب أباه ويسب أمه فيسب أمه. This hadith that we find in Bukhari and Muslim, the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, reviling one's own parents, cursing them, talking evil or bad about them, is one of the greatest sins. So he was asked, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was asked by one of the companions, would anyone even revile their own parents, curse their own parents, talk bad of their own parents? The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, yes, because a person reviles a man's father or curses a man's father, and therefore that man will then curse and revile your own father. And a person reviles another's mother, and then that person will revile the other person's mother. So be mindful of what your tongue is doing. Because from the rights and the etiquettes of the Muslim is that we don't insult or curse or harm one another. And when you do so towards someone's parents, which is whatever land you're in, when you're in an argument, you always get to that point, many get to that point where they start cursing or abusing the mother or the father of that person that they're arguing with. And this is only you reviling or cursing your own parents. From the rights and the etiquettes of the Muslims upon one another, they should not be envious towards one another. Nor should they have bad thoughts about one another. Nor should they hate one another. Nor should they spy on one another. We mentioned this ayah, but it needs to be repeated because unfortunately, we find our tongues not wet with dhikrillah, but instead wet with this revilement or this cursing or this hatred or this envy and the likes of these matters. Allah said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اجْتَنِبُوا كَثِيرًا مِّنَ الظَّنِّ إِنَّ بَعْضَ الظَّنِّ إِثْمٌ وَلَا تَجَسَّسُوا وَلَا يَغْتَبْ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا. Allah says, O you who believe, avoid much suspicion. Indeed, some suspicion is sinful. And do not spy on one another nor backbite one another. Again, the equivalence to eating the flesh of your dead brother. You would hate to do that. So you should hate to spy, to be suspicious, to backbite one another. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, لَا تَحَاسَدُوا وَلَا تَبَاغَدُوا وَلَا تَنَاجَشُوا وَكُونُوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِخْوَانًا. This hadith that we find in Bukhari and Muslim, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded us without any play, do not envy one another. This envy has reached the hearts of the Muslims to a degree I never thought it could reach. This isn't just you're jealous, oh, somebody has something and you don't have it, and maybe you wish you had it. This hasad is the level where you not only wish that you had it, but you wish that it's taken away from them. You wish that they would have that thing you are envying, removed from them and taken away from them, that they may come upon some misery and lose that thing. This is the hasad that we're talking about. And our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us, do not envy except in two matters. One, the man who knows the Quran and he lives in it by the day and the night. And the one who has wealth and spends on it by the day and the night. This is the only two cases of envy you can have. And in that sense, it's not that you want those things taken away from that person. It's just that you wish you could have that or attain that level. Allah's Messenger said, do not envy one another. Do not hate one another. Do not look after each other's faults. Subhanallah, we have mirrors in front of us. And we look at our faces in it. And we see with our eyes the whole body that we have and how the eyes have committed sins and the ears commit sins and the lips commit sins and the tongue commits sins and the hands we look at commit sins and the neck we have that turns to look commits sins and the body as a whole, the legs, they commit sins. And we have the audacity to look at our brother or our sister and look at their faults while our faults reach all faults, reach the heavens and the earth. Our Prophet ﷺ commanded us to not look at the faults of one another and do not inflate prices against one another, but be brethren. Be brothers in Islam, servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Iyyakum wadh-dhann, fa inna adh-dhann akdhabul hadith." And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in the hadith, Sahih in Bukhari and Muslim, avoid suspicion, for suspicion is the falseness of speech. We know the reference in English, but all you do is make a fool out of yourself when you suspect of someone something that may not be true. And because of this, you find what shaitan leads you down, you start to spread that suspicion. And this is the falsest and the worst of speech. The last point we will cover from the rights and the etiquettes of the Muslim on the Muslim is that we should not deceive or cheat one another. We should not deceive or cheat anybody for that matter. But even to deceive and cheat your brother in Islam or sister in Islam is a graver sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَمَنْ يَكْسِبْ خَطِيئَةً أَوْ إِثْمًا ثُمَّ يَرْمِي بِهِ بَرِيئًا فَقَدْ اِحْتَمَلَ بُهْتَانًا وَإِثْمًا مُبِينًا. Allah says what means, and whoever earns a fault or a sin, they're the ones who did it. They're the ones who committed the wrong. But then they throw that sin on somebody else who is innocent. He has indeed burdened himself with falsehood and manifest sin. Imagine on the day of resurrection, standing before your Creator, as if يعني, he didn't know what you were doing. He had no knowledge of your thoughts, of your actions, of your deeds. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. Allah is all-knowing, all-hearing, all-seeing, and fully aware. But in this dunya, you still, to protect yourself or to advance yourself, you took a sin that you did and you threw it on someone innocent. Imagine facing your Creator on the day of resurrection 50,000 years long. Because in reality, this is denying that Allah knows everything, hears everything, sees everything. When you do such an evil or such a sin. قَالَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَا مِنْ عَبْدٍ يَسْتَرْعِيهِ اللَّهُ رَعِيَّةً يَمُوتُ يَوْمَ يَمُوتُ وَهُوَ غَاشٌ لِرَعِيَّتِهِ إِلَّا حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ. رواه بخاري ومسلم. Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said in the authentic hadith, if Allah puts any servant, any human in charge of a people, and at the time of his death, he was deceiving or cheating them, the people he was in charge of, Allah will forbid paradise for him or for her. Allah will forbid Jannah for this person, for their deception and their cheating over the people you're in charge of. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah sent this deen down with etiquettes that we should fulfill to all of humanity, and then rights and etiquettes that as brothers and sisters in Islam we have over one another. May Allah make us of those who fulfill them. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka anta sami'un qareebun mujib ad da'awat ya muqallib al qulub thabbit quluban ala dinik ya muqallib al qulub thabbit quluban ala dinik ya muqallib al qulub thabbit quluban ala dinik subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun ala al mursalin walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.